We're always staring up into space, trying to figure out what we're seeing. And we like to think we know what's going on, but what if we've been seeing it wrong this whole time? Okay, a little context here. Almost all normal galaxies have a supermassive black hole at the center, including ours. That's not freaky at all. But we can't actually see the black holes themselves. They're so dense and their gravitational field is so strong that nothing can escape them, not even light. So we observe them instead by seeing how all the matter around them behaves. All the stuff in these galaxies is very slowly falling in toward the black hole, causing the galaxy to spiral and form into a disk shape. Some of these galaxies are special though. The supermassive black hole is consuming more than the normal amount of the galaxy around it, and faster. It's greedy. These are what we call active galactic nuclei, or AGN for short. As the matter in the galaxy gets closer to the black hole, it heats up and produces all kinds of radiation. We've got radio, we've got infrared, X-ray, gamma ray. It's a big party. This is called an accretion disk, and even though we can't see the black hole itself, the accretion disk around it is one of the things we can observe when we're looking at AGN. Accretion disks are just one of a few characteristics that form our standard model for what AGN might look like. Other typical features include gigantic jets that eject stuff and a torus, which is like a big donut of galactic material. Depending on the circumstances though, we may not see all the features we're expecting, and different AGN appear to have different properties. We've currently classified tens of different kinds based on observations of things like brightness, size, jets, lack of jets, and type of radiation emitted. They're divided into radio quiet and radio loud nuclei, and each of these types contains categories of its own, like Seyfert galaxies, quasars, and blazars, and each of these categories has their own subdivisions as well. But there's a theory that posits something a little radical called AGN unification theory. First proposed back in 1993, it claims that essentially all AGN are the same, but they just look different to us based on their orientation in space. I mean, we're limited, right? We can't exactly go out and fly around them to see them in 360. We're only seeing them from our perspective here on Earth. However, supercomputers may be able to help us figure this out. With simulations, we can model AGN, allowing us to twist and turn them, seeing what they look like and what signals they give off from different angles. But these models aren't the perfect answer to figuring out if AGN unification theory is right. We probably don't even have all the necessary data to make the most accurate models of galactic behavior. But as we continue to get better at detecting the signals coming from them, building more powerful telescopes, and asking even better questions, hopefully we'll get there soon. Isn't it kind of awesome and mind-blowing to think about this? Since the many different kinds of AGN have already been meticulously observed and grouped by attribute, it can be easy as a non-astrophysicist to say, yep, there they are, all the different kinds of active galactic nuclei. Aren't we good at looking at and labeling things? But then something like the AGN unification theory comes along and suggests that this may be all irrelevant because we haven't taken into account something as seemingly simple as perspective. It really makes you feel like there's so much more to be discovered, and our understanding of our universe is so much more malleable than we might think. Science isn't a set of hard and fast rules, it's changing all the time, and that might be my favorite part. Make sure to subscribe down below to be the first to know if AGN unification theory turns out to be right, and check out this video here on what happens when galaxies collide. Also, quasars are AGN whose cores are so bright that they outshine all the stars in their galaxy, and quasar stands for quasi-stellar radio sources. I'm Marin. Thanks for watching, Seeker.